In this video, we are going to discuss about initial value theorem in Laplace transforms. So here, initial value theorem states that if you know spectrum or frequency domain of any unknown function, then it is easy to trace the initial value of the function. For example, if you know spectrum, but if you don't know the time domain of that spectrum, or if you don't know the signal related to that spectrum, you can trace the starting point or initial value of that spectrum, that is nothing but at t equivalent to 0 plus. If f of t, if you want to find that f of t value at t is equal to 0 plus, you can find by using that spectrum. So you can see the definition. If the transform f of s of an unknown function f of t is known, then it is possible to determine the initial value of f of t, that is the value of f of t at t is equivalent to 0 plus. If f of t and its first derivative or Laplace transformable, then the initial value of f of t is f of 0 plus is equivalent to limit s tending to infinity s into f of s. If you know f of s, you can trace the initial value of the function which you don't know. So this theorem especially we are going to apply when spectrum is known and signal is unknown. So if they are asking only initial value, then we can use this theory. And here, for better understanding, I want to consider a problem. I have a spectrum f of s is equivalent to 1 by s plus 1. I want to consider my spectrum f of s is equivalent to 1 by s plus 1. I know this spectrum. This is the frequency domain of any signal f of t, but I don't know that signal, whether that f of t is a sine or f of t is a cos or f of t is a exponential, I don't know. But I can trace the initial value of that time domain signal by using this theorem. So that means if you want signal initial value, that means f of 0 plus, you can easily trace by using this formula s tending to infinity s into f of s. That means limit s tending to infinity s into f of s place, you are having 1 by s plus 1. So here I am taking common of s in this. So limit s tending to infinity s into 1 by, if you take in common of s, you will get 1 by s, 1 plus 1 by s. S will get cancelled, and if I applied s tending to infinity, 1 by infinity will become 0. So finally you are going to get 1 by 1, that is equivalent to 1. So the initial value of the signal related to this spectrum is equivalent to 1. That means the initial value starts at the value 1. So like this, you can trace the value of signal, initial value of the signal, when its spectrum is known. So this is very, very important throughout the signals and systems. Initial value theorem is very important. Initial value theorem, you will get limit s tends to infinity. In next class, you will go for final value theorem. There you are having f of infinity, there you will get limit s tends to 0. So just you need to take s tends to 0 for final value. As this is initial value, you need to consider limit s tends to infinity. These two formulas you need to keep in mind. These formulas are not only useful in signals and systems, but also useful in control systems topics also. So by using initial value theorem, we can trace the initial value of unknown signal when its spectrum is known.